It's a great win. It was a great win for us. We'll take it and move on to our next opponent.
Holly, in the game, you guys had 18 turnovers, just to shoot 20 of 21 from the line. How clutch was that just to come away with?
Well, for us to shoot 95, it's huge percent. So we put in the time, and I think this game, obviously, it was a huge bonus for us to be able to knock down the free throws. I can't remember last time we shot 95%. It's huge.
Holly, Jordan was talking about you, the coaches today, I heard it, to be more aggressive.
Yeah.
I go back to that game last year in the tournament against Kentucky where that's all she did. And she said sometimes she gets caught up watching the other players that defense are so good and she loses her aggressiveness.
Well, I thought, John, the last two games she has played very average, and I spoke pretty sternly with her, and I hope that she continues what she did tonight. She was aggressive, solid on the defensive end. I thought she pushed the basketball. She hit big shots. You know, she's having to get people to go where they need to be as a point guard. And I'm asking her to do a lot of things. But, see, you saw her against Kentucky. I've seen her. So, now nothing else is acceptable. So, my expectations for her is play like tonight in the Kentucky games. And I'm not going to stay off of her.
When you talk about her, kind of the chores she's entrusted with in terms of getting everybody, does that get away with players or point guards a lot of the times?
I don't. You know, I think that that's what point guards do, and they take on that responsibility. I don't even think that she thinks, wow, I've got the biggest responsibility. I think she just plays, and she loves the game, and she plays it hard. When she plays hard with great effort, that's the Jordan we know, and when she's not into it, then that I don't – we don't like Jordan then, so But I just think she's, you know, you're a point guard, and she knows it. She's gone to – we've sat down and talked. She's been a point guard pretty much her whole career and 1-2 guard, and it's in her blood. And when you are – I think Jordan's a great leader on the court. She knows who to get people the ball. She knows when she needs to shoot. So she's just done a great job for us this year. Well, I think it was a combination of both. I think the game was real physical. Izzy, I don't know what she played the first half, but, you know, our best player can't be sitting on the bench with playing two. I don't know what she played. And then Sierra was out too. And then we missed, you know, I thought we missed – we got great looks and we missed them. We missed, I think, four layups in one segment. Drea missed a layup. Lexa missed a layup, so it kind of snowballed. And I thought we took some good – my problem with us the first half and probably a large part of the night is we shot the ball quickly. Ariel had a shot transition quickly. So those are the type of things that if we're not shooting the ball well, come out, make them play defense, let's move it around and get a good shot. But when you're not hitting, you're not scoring, you just can't shoot the ball quickly. A lot of times we were shooting and nobody was down under the basket to rebound. So but I'll go back and watch it and see, but that's, I'm just telling you, we shot the ball too quickly tonight.
How do you let Alexa and Jamie play through some mistakes?
Yep. Well, all of them. I thought Courtney Dunbar came in and hit a big three. I thought she was solid. I do. I think Eric told me Sierra and Izzy and they didn't score the first half, and so the people off the bench carried us and got us through that first half. So Jamie's is just, we want her to be aggressive. Don't settle for the three. Attack the basket. be a great rebounder. Alexa as well. Just play as hard as you can. Court needs to shoot the three and just do your role and do it well.
How much was this game just a test of the depth for both teams, particularly y'all, with Ariel and just being held scoreless as long as they were in there?
That was huge. I mean, it kept us in the game the first half. Our bench kept us in the game the first half. So, and we keep preaching to them, your time is coming. It's coming. And today, their time, they stepped up and did some big things. So, and it's just going to continue, and they're going to have to step up like Jordan did last year in the SEC tournament. They're going to have to hit a big shot. And so that's why we continue to tell them to be patient, keep working hard in practice, and do the things that we're asking you to do, and your time will pay off. Yeah. Well, we try to. I do, Dan. I think we've just spent a lot of time on it, and this team seems to be understanding the importance of it. So tonight, yeah, I wanted us to stop jump shooting the basketball and try to get inside and not so much draw a foul, but attack the basket. And we stepped up and hit big. You know, we don't hit big free throws. We don't win the game. I think anybody that's competitive, John, and has played throughout high school, I think it's hard for anyone to sit on the bench and know their time is coming. But that's a part of what we stress as a team, and you've got to buy into it. You've got to buy into it. Isabel Harrison, a freshman year, played, I think, 5 minutes. I don't know. You look at Ariel Massengale. She was named the starting point guard before she even got to Tennessee, and now she's coming off the bench. So it's what's important to you in the end result. So we talk a lot of it. Tonight we talked a lot about team. It wasn't about me. It's about what we can do as a team. And until they grasp that, they have to, because you're worried about the wrong things instead of focusing on what I need to do. And I think every team goes through it. And we've got kids that we think can contribute, but some right now more than others. And it's a team game. And when somebody's not scoring, somebody has to come in and take up the slack.
All right, Coach, thank you very
much. All right,
thank
you.